Your last choice is one of my favorite albums of all time as well. Marvin Gaye, What's Going On? And talking about protest as well is really interesting. I mean, Motown was kind of a pop label, a pop soul label owned by Berry Gordy, African American. So it wasn't political in the sense of the kind of music it put out in the 1960s. It was called The Sound of Young America. But the fact that it was owned by a black man in the 1960s and was one of the most successful labels of that decade, that had top 10 singles every week, it had singles in the charts every week, I think that's a political statement. Bands like The Temptations and also The Four Tops with Still Waters Run Deep, by the late 1960s, they had kind of wanted to express themselves and align themselves with the counterculture movement, the hippie movement, the real political movement, anti-Vietnam, anti-war, pro-civil rights, pro-feminism, equality for all, very idealistic utopian values. And Marvin Gaye really wanted to follow suit, but he was kind of known as more of a crooner. He had great success as well. I heard it through the grapevine. And then also he collaborated with what he called his soulmate, Tammy Terrell. She sadly passed away from a brain tumor, and he was absolutely devastated. This is around the turn of the decade, from the 1960s to the 1970s. He had a cousin, I believe, who was in the Vietnam War, and he felt helpless. He felt like he, you know, was singing these songs that really meant nothing to him. And he really wanted to make an album that was a socially conscious and political statement. And Berry Gordy really didn't want it to happen, but he did give Marvin the chance. And when Berry first heard it, he said, "That's the worst album I've ever heard. So worst thing I've ever heard." But they put it out anyways. And the rest is history. It's an album that addresses environmental degradation, poverty, social injustice, inflation, war, and it's still as relevant today as it was when it was released nearly 50 years ago. So tell us, how did you first discover Marvin Gaye, What's Going On?
I don't remember, because I feel like I've been listening to it since I was born, and it's sort of been a bit of a soundtrack to my upbringing since pre-birth. Mm-hmm. So I don't think I discovered it. I think it was one that might have been, like, under my skin, to quote Frank Sinatra.
It's like osmosis.
Yeah. And also a kind of key album that did what I spoke about happening in my teens, in my sort of parents' era of music, that did that same thing. So it was like he was sort of known to be the soul music guy, and other people like Bob Dylan and all that were sort of the ones who spoke about social injustice and stuff. And then he obviously said, "No, like, I want to use my platform to do that." And he did it in his own formidable style. Mm-hmm. And I think both the amazing thing about this album and the terrible thing about this album is that every single song is relevant today. It makes it a classic album because it's timeless, but it also emphasises how little progress humanity has made and the inevitability of, like, how destructive we are, really. Because you can listen to any one of these songs and think nothing's changed. So you said everything else, the reason why it was amazing.
Well, the thing that's also incredible is the real artistic statement from beginning to end. I mean, it almost is like one piece. And It is one of these records that just sinks into your subconscious, because it's one of these records that I think I know all the lyrics from beginning to end without even knowing it.
Yeah, and I think as well what makes it really different and sets it aside from other political albums as well is that it's personal. Mm. So it sounds like a guy just sort of saying in his... It could be like to his friend or something, like things like brother, brother, and even just the question, what's going on? It's like so innocent and naive and like, what's happening? Like, or just like it's not pointed. It's just very personal, and anybody who is not even political, but with a heart, would be able to empathise with what he's saying.
Yeah.
And I think that's why it's timeless. That's why it appeals to the masses, because you don't have to be a political person to understand what he's saying in these lyrics.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's not like, it's not dogmatic. It's not telling you to do something. It's just asking you to think and to consider the situation.
And it's not angry, it's not confrontational. It's just like, this is tragic.
And he also, interestingly, never introduces race into it. He never mentions black people, and he consciously did this. I think, of course, African Americans identify maybe even more than white Americans with some of the statements he said on this album. But he really didn't want to make it. He wanted it to be for all people and
about
for everybody,
humankind.
About humans. Yeah. Absolutely. Well, you picked the title track.
Yeah.
So.
It summarizes the whole thing, but it's worth listening to the whole album, but we'd have to lock the doors and not let anyone
some other time. Let's have a listen.
There's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you crying.